iPhone users, this video is for you. I'm going to show 10 iPhone settings you need to change right now. I can guarantee you there's at least 5 settings that most people don't know about. One of the coolest iPhone features that I remember Apple showing on stage is live voicemail. Now this hasn't been available in India, but there's an iPhone setting to enable this. Just go to settings and change the language to English US first, and then change the region too. Then open phone settings and turn on the live voicemail option. If it was turned on for you, just do a quick turn off and turn on. Now whenever you get a call, you'll see a voicemail button here. Just tap that and the call will go to voicemail, and you'll be able to see whatever the other person is speaking converted to text. And if it's important, you can accept the call right away. You can also listen to the voicemail and its transcript later in the phone app. This is quite useful to avoid all annoying spam calls. Haptics on iPhone are great, but not many people know that you can make the haptics even faster. It makes a huge difference. All you need to do is go to Settings, Accessibility, Touch, and here you will find Haptic Touch. Just change this to Fast. Now, when you're doing different actions with haptics, you'll see a difference. The haptics just become more responsive. Okay, so the next iPhone setting that you must enable is under privacy. It's called Sensitive Content Warning, and this will detect if you are getting an inappropriate photo or video, and then it'll blur the media. And only when you hit show, you'll see the photo or video. This works in iMessage, AirDrop, and even video messages. This is a very important privacy feature as it will help a lot of people, especially women who receive a lot of inappropriate images online. Hope this feature is expanded to other apps too. A lot of us like using our iPhones like this, especially during the night, and the truth is, this isn't good for eyes. Well, there's an option in screen time called screen distance, and this will use Face ID in your iPhone to alert you when the screen is too close to your face. This is what the warning looks like, and this is available even on iPads, which is super useful with kids using iPhone and iPad these days. One cool lock screen customization option that you need to try is Photo Shuffle. You can now choose an entire album as your wallpaper, and this will cycle through its photos, and you can set a shuffle frequency and even choose from different styles. I have set it to shuffle after tap, and now whenever I tap on screen, the wallpaper changes. Who thought iOS would come this far with customization? Has this ever happened to you? You're sharing your screen in an important meeting and your friend sends a funny message, and everyone on the call can see it. Just go to Settings, Screen Sharing, and turn this off. And this will enable DND whenever you're sharing your screen. Trust me, this feature is a lifesaver. Same way, you can also disable notifications in standby mode. If you hit OTP clutter in your messages, you need to turn on this setting. In the settings, you need to enable this option under passwords like this, and from now on, it will automatically delete the OTP from messages or even after they are used by autofill. If you want to keep your personal data secure in case your iPhone is stolen, this new setting is for you. This will make sure that they can't change your Apple ID password without your Face ID. Or view passwords, disable Find My, add or remove Face ID, PIN. They can't even reset the iPhone without your Face ID. This feature will not work if the iPhone is in the trusted location. So it will kick in only when you are in non-trusted location. At the time of shooting this video, this feature is available only in beta, but it will be out for everyone soon. Look, not many people know that iPhone's camera app has a level feature that's super useful for people like me who love taking tilted photos. You just need to enable the level option in the camera settings, and once done, you'll see the camera level in the middle of the frame. Enable this in your friend's iPhone first so that they can take proper photos of you from now on. The last setting is for iPhone users that have an AirTag. One of the most useful new iOS 17 features is the ability to share AirTags with your family. You can add up to 5 people, which is useful for sharing common things like keys and bag. These were some of the unknown iPhone settings that I found. But if there's some more cool iPhone settings that you know, make sure to comment and let everyone know. Thanks for watching.